Welcome to part 4 of my Crash Bandicoot 2 Let's Play. And this time we're going to start in Warp Room 4. Only have two rooms left to go with the main story, with the 25 crystals. So, alright, let's get started. First level is hanging out. I believe this is another sewer level. Say it's the last sewer level, so it's gonna be everything. They're gonna throw everything at us this time. Literally. Those guys, you just want to fall, or will you return to a ghost? Either way, you die. You touch them. You either ghost crash or you fall. I don't remember which. I really don't want to find out right now, so just gotta avoid them. Some of the enemies you just can't kill. And here, you can avoid these guys by putting your legs up in the air, but I only do that if I need to. Like on some of the bonus stages, you have to do that in order to pass it. And that's the only time I really do it, so. Just keep moving. Most of the time you're pretty good. Don't have much to worry about. That's what I'm saying. That's not a thing, is it? No. Back here is like a gym area, I believe. Let's check it out. I wanna say it's a gym area. Parts I was talking about. As you see here, you kind of need to use that functionality. And your legs just hanging low enough where it'll hit you. Totally hit the bonus part and didn't even want to. Well, this is the sixth warp room, and it's basically like a bonus. Helps you get the rest of the gems. It's all good. That's the first one of these levels we've seen so far. But you have this bug that follows you around, gives you light through the stage. If you would spin that one that I jumped on, then I believe you would blow up. I'm pretty sure. That's why it's always safe just to jump on them if you think something bad would happen. Fun. And I wasn't sure how much longer the bonus level was, so that's why I just left the life back there. But I don't really need it, so nothing really lost. Because I didn't want to be stuck in there with no light. And this just comes from experience. I have no idea how many of these there are. I just know when you hit the peaches, you just thought it was the hole there. You can hear them. Alright. I think I'm good. Yep, got them all. You don't have enough time to get them with the light. So if you want to guess where those holes are, you know, you can, but I just... I'd do that to get the bosses. And jump. Even though I didn't mean to go there, you know, might as well pick up the gem while you're there. Those, you can't spin them, but you can jump on them, and you can slam them, and that's how you get rid of them. But most of the time, you can just avoid them. And don't hit their explosive seeds. That's bad. Sometimes there's a TNT in there. Not necessarily on this part, but I know sometimes when you can't see exactly what's there, there'll be an explosive waiting for you. Which is, you know, wonderful. I believe there was a life in there, but like I said, we don't really need it at this point. If you're desperate for lives, you know, lives though, you know, getting those would be definitely be helpful. You know, I kind of want to go over there. You know, I'm not doing that right now, but oh well. I may do a little series after the main Let's Play that focuses on getting 100%, because this is like one of my favorite games. So especially if anyone's interested in watching it, I mean, would totally be worth my time to do it. In Underground, you're pretty much invincible to anything other than the TNT boxes. The hammer guys that you haven't seen yet, but they're out there, so you'll see them in a second. It's the only thing that can hurt you under the ground like that. That guy. Usually you can outrun the bees, so they don't pose too much of a threat. See, if I would've went the other way, I could've got the other six boxes, but it's all good. We would've had to do a little bit of backtracking, but it's all good.
Something is not right with his statements. Beware of the tricks.
Alright, Cold War Crash. I can remember, I believe. I don't know. I think it's the last snow level. I think it is. Pretty sure. Total guess though. I have no idea. I have nothing to definite to say about that right now. They just made me antsy. Cold already. So if this is the last snow level, it'll definitely be the most challenging that we've done so far. Pretty much all the same. Explosion. Hiding behind bosses. After hitting your first one, you'll be very skeptical of things you can't see. Two mass. That's what you want to do, is spin it into the bots. Doesn't always work out, but if you can get it, definitely makes your life easier. I guess all in all, it was worth getting that bonus just for the gem, because they look nice. The gems look nice, you know. Behavior. It's gonna be like digging it, except a lot more bees. Don't know how else to describe it. And more, actually. I believe there's like 3-4 bees coming after you instead of just one. And they can't get you on the ground, so it all works out. Instead of one. It's definitely annoying being chased by them guys. That close to him, but okay. Useless lives now, just being wasted, which is quite a shame, actually.
Crash, I have discovered that the opposition is being masterminded by Dr. Nictris Brio, the inventor of the Evolvo Ray. Brio was responsible for our misunderstandings in the past. He forced me to assist him in his plot for world domination, and he's at it again. He will attempt to stand in our way. Be on your guard, Crash. Use the platform to deliver the crystals to Angel.
You know, we've heard that before.
Like Dr. Cortex said, eat the 20 crystals you have collected from me.
Thank you.
That engine's so funny. Definitely one of my favorite villains. Just dancing in front of his face.
What is your problem, Bandicoot? I will not ask you again to bring me the crystals! Obtain the remaining 5 crystals, Crash, and bring them to me!
Alright, well that concludes the 4th part of my Crash Bandicoot 2 Let's Play. If you liked it, then like, comment, and let me know what you think. Thank you.